Hello and welcome to Concert Pipeline. I'm Steve Jones. Today on the program, we have a music episode. No band interviews or anything along those lines, but we're going to play some concert footage from Yellowcard show with Third Eye Blind at Shoreline a couple of weeks back. Talk about that concert and really a couple of memories around that sort of thing along the way. So going to get into that shortly. But before we do, give a little update on what's going on in my world. I am now, as of the recording of this, 3 days away from my cruise with my kids. I've taken them down to Ensenada and Catalina Island. So I'm in full vacation mode and ready to go. So I can't wait. It's going to be a blast. And I'm just looking forward to it and really need to start packing and getting my stuff together, figuring out what I need to buy to be able to get ready. Mostly a large investment in sunscreen because I burn heavily. And so I'll need to be caked in sunscreen so I don't become crispy and peel like a freaking iguana or something. That is what's happening there. Couple of days over the 4th of July weekend, we'll talk about what I did there. I had my daughter's friend over. They got to go to see Noah Kahan out at Wheatland. I took them it was 114 degrees or some nonsense like that, but by the time we got there and got in and sat on the lawn, it was probably down to just over 100, and the sun was setting, so it wasn't miserable. But Noah Kahan finally took the stage around 10 p.m. and I might share some stories or some video from that in the next episode. We'll see. I recorded a couple of songs, but my daughter had a great time. It's their favorite artist, and they were super excited to sing along in my daughter's friend's case, yell along the lyrics and really just go crazy. They had such a great time at that show. When we eventually got home at 2 a.m., I slept for 3.5 hours, and the next day got them moving, and we went to the Oakland A's game where they took on the Angels and beat them 5-0. It was a good game and free Hawaiian t-shirt day. So I'll take that as well, I guess. It was pretty enjoyable. I got to shuttle kids around the bay, and then did fireworks last night, where my kid stepdad likes to get some pretty heavy duty fireworks, and we put them off in a safe location and celebrate our independence, I suppose, I guess is what that's all about. But it's a lot of fun, and so I've just been going and keeping busy and doing my thing, and really just can't wait to just relax on a boat and just have a week where I don't have any cares or any worries in the world and don't have to worry about it. It'll be fun, and have fun with my kids, eat a lot of food that I shouldn't eat, drink a lot of drinks that I probably shouldn't drink, and just relax and not worry. It sounds too good to be true, because I don't know. I don't vacation very often. I don't get out often, but I'm looking forward to it a lot. And so that's coming up. All right. So let's talk about the concert, the Yellowcard show with Third Eye Blind. And Arizona opened the show. This is at Shoreline, which is pretty far for me to go for a concert. It's like over an hour and a half away. It took over 2 hours to get there, including sitting in a line to get in and park and everything along those lines. So a lot of driving to get out to Mountain View. I don't go to many shows at Shoreline anymore, but this one seemed worth it, and I got a ticket through Yellowcard. I actually got two tickets, and then there was a lady who was trying to get pick up a ticket also, and her ticket wasn't there or available, and I gave her my extra ticket so that she was able to get in and didn't have to worry about buying a ticket or anything along those lines. Um, but Was supposed to have a yellow card on as an interview, and that fell through. Maybe one day it'll happen. We'll see. But they're very busy right now on tour. This is a long tour that they have with Third Eye Blind also. And again, Arizona opened the show. So before I start talking about yellow card, let's get the music going a little bit. Let's play a song by Arizona. I got there, I think in the middle of their set, toward the end of their set. After the time, by the time I finally got in the venue, and this is the song that they closed with called "Freaking Out." Here it is. Freaking Out by Arizona here on Concert Pipeline. And now we get to talk about Yellowcard. And Yellowcard is one of those bands that I've seen a couple times, at least one or two times. I want to say that I've seen Yellowcard over the years. And famously, they broke up, I think, probably around 2009. And I don't think they had any intention getting back together. Ryan Key went off and made his own music and did okay with that. But people love him for his yellow card music and the band, and then there's the whole nostalgia factor. People love to relive their youths, and I'm no exception to that. I'm going to see something corporate in 2 weeks up in Seattle. I can't even wait for when they're going to be here in October to see them again live. And I'm big on the nostalgia thing, so I get it. But that Reinke said in interviews with the Rolling Stone and other sources that they're playing bigger venues now than they were when before they broke up. And it's crazy to him that that's happening. And sure, there's some new music, but it's, I think people come for the hits and the Ocean Avenue got it, and all of the that sort of thing. So, and we'll play a couple of songs from Yellowcard. But I'll I mentioned something corporate. I actually saw Yellowcard and something corporate together in Chico in 2004. They had toured together, and it was a good show. I mean, just such a good set for both of the bands. I really, really enjoyed it. And then I met Andrew McMahon after the show, and I had already interviewed him, I think the earlier in the year, or the year. Yeah, it was. I think it was that same year. I had already interviewed him, so there was a familiarity there. And then I was meeting up with a friend and another, and someone and their roommate or what have you, and so I stayed late, and then I remember when I was leaving, the tour buses were actually also leaving. The show had fully been wrapped up. It was late, and I remember getting on the freeway, and I'm in between Yellowcard and something corporate's tour buses as they're driving on the freeway. I was Both of the buses are leaving at the same time. I was right in between them. It was just pretty funny. This cool little this moment. And then I veer off and they went their own way. I didn't follow them or anything, but it was pretty funny. So that was my Yellowcard story. And I'm sure I saw them at Warped Tour or something along the way as well. A good band, and I dig them. So we're gonna play a song by Yellowcard. This is the song that they opened with, a song that I like actually. It's called Lights and Sounds. was Lights and Sounds by Yellowcard. And yeah, we got another song to play. But I'll say that their set was legit. It was very solid. Their show at Shoreline Amphitheatre. They Ryan Key had showed a lot of appreciation for where they're at in the world, and just, I mean, emphasized kind of the things he was saying to Rolling Stone in terms of like being so fortunate to get to be back together with the guys in that band, and get to play those songs and just be there, be present, like, and having he said at one point if he'd have told his 12 or 14-year-old self that they would be sharing the same stage with Third Eye Blind and touring with them, that he wouldn't believe it. And he is, Third Eye Blind brought him out on this tour, this very expensive tour, and I'm sure he's showing the same appreciation every night of the tour, just for where he's at in that moment. And his bandmates agree, and they put on a great rock show. It was really enjoyable. And so I'm going to play one more song from Yellowcard's set at Shoreline Amphitheatre. And of course, this is the song that they closed with. It's a song we also need to play as well, because it's a great one. It's one I love when they come up, when it comes up on like the pop punk rides on Peloton. It is Ocean Avenue by Yellowcard. Avenue by Yellowcard, and I can't help but think when I hear that song, I have a friend who used to live off Ocean Avenue in San Francisco. And every time I got off on that exit to visit my friend, that I would, that song goes in your head. I don't know. I wonder if it's the same for him. I know I've asked him about it once, living off of Ocean Avenue, and he's had it brought up to by other people, of course. I think he could probably get out of his head about it. But just when you're when I'm getting off the Ocean Avenue exit, there's a place off Ocean Avenue, it goes into my head. It's just there, and it's great. So that is Yellowcard, and of course they played with Third Eye Blind, and in Third Eye Blind, I saw last year they played in Napa, and Take Me Back Sunday opened for them. So I'd actually seen them recently, but before that, I think it had been 20 something years since I'd seen Third Eye Blind play in Concord at the amphitheater there. And I remember Stephen Jenkins going out into the crowd and halfway through the amphitheater and singing a song in the middle of the amphitheater. And he didn't do that at this show, but he did play a really fun set and change the stage up a little bit. Midway through the set for a couple songs, a couple acoustic songs, that sort of thing. So let's play a song by Third Eye Blind, and then we'll talk a little bit more. We're going to play Motorcycle Drive By. This is one of their early songs that they played recently.
Summertime and the wind is blowing outside, and they just seem, I don't know what I'm doing in the city. The sun is always in my eyes. It crashes through the windows. I'm sleeping on the couch when I came to visit you. That's what I knew, that I could never have you. I knew that before you did. Girl, I'm the one who's stupid. And there's this burning like there's always been. Never been so alone. Never been so alone. Visions of you on a motorcycle drive by. Cigarette ash flies in your eyes and your mind. You smile. Say the world, it doesn't fit with you. I don't believe you. You're so serene. Go into the universe, show axis on the tilt. Your guiltless and free. I hope you take a piece of me with you. And there's things I would like to do that you don't believe in. I would like to build something, yeah. You'll never see it happen. And in these burning like there's always been. I'm never been so alone. And I say take me home.
Motorcycle Drive-By by Third Eye Blind, and so this is a show. I mean, there were a lot of songs that I didn't know. I'm not a super huge Third Eye Blind fan, but I did grow up in the 90s, and so I know the hits that were on the radio and maybe a couple others past that, but getting to hear the hits are always enjoyable, I do enjoy the songs that I don't know as well. Sometimes, like it's just, you know, getting to hear a stripped down acoustic song. You're an artist kind of being in that spotlight with thousands and thousands of people watching. Is just enjoyable, even if you don't know the song. And Stephen Jenkins being from the band Third Eye Blind being from the Bay Area. He talked several times about going to shows at Shoreline Amphitheatre and never, it was always the lawn. He always, went to shows and sat on the lawn. So he talked to the people on the lawn, you know, up on the lawn a bit, but he never played a show at Shoreline Amphitheatre, which is surprising to me for a band of their stature who's been around for 30 plus years that's from the Bay Area. So that was interesting to know. So, okay, let's play another song by Third Eye Blind, because that's what we're doing today. We're playing music. And this one will bring out a hit. We're going to play Never Let You Go by Third Eye Blind.
Thank you.
You go by Third Eye Blind, and that's going to take us on to the next segment, the music news. A couple stories to wind us out, and we're gonna go ahead and close out with one more song by Third Eye Blind, because we're playing music on this episode. That's what we do. We're gonna play some songs from the show, and it'll be fun. So all right, so AC/DC played two nights at Wembley Stadium, and they played a 21 song set that featured plenty of classics, and they had some from their comeback record Power Up, where they dedicated it to Malcolm. Let me see. I think they started with If You Want Blood, You've Got It from their 1979 album Highway to Hell, before, of course, they played Back in Black. Their classic songs from across their 50-year career, as well as a couple of the most recent album. They played Thunderstruck, Hell's Bells, Shoot to Thrill, Rock and Roll Train, and of course Dirty Deeds Done Cheap, all got played. They finished their main set with You Shook Me All Night Long, Highway to Hell, Whole Lotta Rosie, and Let There Be Rock, during which the whole crowd is treated to a 20-minute Angus Young guitar solo, which is incredible that Angus Young could just still have a guitar solo for 20 freaking minutes. That's bonkers. This is bonkers to me, but I love it. And it was so cool to get to see AC/DC. I've never gotten to see him live. And I'm actually going to get the chance to talk to someone who's in AC/DC for a couple of years. I think, what's his name? I'm going to pull up here. Oh, Chris Slade is his name. And he's going to be on our guest on the next episode of Concert Pipeline. We'll talk about his time in AC/DC. But just to know that they're still going and going strong. They had a two-song encore, which included TNT and For Those About to Rock, We Salute You. So epic, epic set by AC/DC. It just would have been so cool to be at that show. Okay, Elvis Presley's blue suede shoes sold for a huge amount at auction. A pair of blue suede shoes worn by Elvis himself has sold for a dynamite amount. They sold for £120,000 on June 28th at the top end of they were expecting between 100 and 120,000 pounds. And Presley first acquired the shoes after he performed the Carl Perkins hit Blue Suede Shoes, and wore the shoes for various interviews and public appearances throughout the 1950s, most notably on the Steve Allen Show in the US, in which he performed Hound Dog. And when he was drafted into the US Army in the late 50s, he gave the shoes to a friend. And the auctioneer said the shoes are what you would think of immediately when you talk about Elvis Presley, and they transcend popular culture. And apparently someone agreed that a pair of his shoes is worth £120,000. Pretty, pretty incredible. All right. Will Smith performed a new song at the BET Awards. He made his comeback on June 30th. Following his highly publicized slapping incident with Chris Rock at the 2022 Academy Awards, he performed his new song, You Can Make It, at the ceremony. He stood in a circle of fire with a setting that resembled an apocalyptic landscape. And behind him, a large sun rose on the screen. And Smith told the audience, I don't know who needs to hear this right now, but whatever's going on in your life, I'm here to tell you, you can make it. So some of the lyrics include, the darker the hell you gotta endure, the brighter the heaven you get to enjoy, the harder the fall, the higher you soar, God opens a window when the devil closes the door. So it seems like Will Smith has turned to God for a lot of help with his situation with Chris Rock and like the aftermath of that. I mean, I'm sure there's a lot of processing he's had to go through, and he's turned to religion to help him out there. And he played this song on BET. So yeah, you could see a clip of it online if you'd like. More interesting to me than that is Michael J. Fox and Coldplay recreated Back to the Future live in concert. Coldplay kicked off the North American leg of their Head Full of Dreams tour just outside New York. They were, let me see here. And I know Michael J. Fox. He was diagnosed with Parkinson's in 1991. He's been known to reprise the famous scene with annual benefits for his Michael J. Fox Foundation. And for the 2013 benefit, he performed alongside Chris Martin in New York City. But it's been over a decade since then. And he was on stage. I think he was sitting in a wheelchair. I checked out the performance, but he played with Chris Martin, and they did Earth Angel and Johnny Be Good. I mean, what a cool instance to have a treasure like Michael J. Fox there playing with Coldplay. That would have been really cool. All right, and last story for the music news. Is Dave Grohl attended the Wimbledon tennis tournament and has given his predictions as to who will win. He recently wrapped a UK tour with his band. He traded his usual rock star garb of jeans, a t-shirt, and long flowing locks for a clean-cut suit and tie with brown loafers while appearing at Wimbledon. And he was there with his wife, Jordan Bloom. He was stopped by the BBC for a quick interview about his predictions for the tournament winners. And whenever you say interview, we use that term lightly. They stuck a microphone in his face as he's walking. And after being asked about who he thought would win, he initially replied, "What?" And a second time he repeated, "What?" before adding on the potential men's champion. No clue. Grohl was then asked about who he thought would win the women's event, which he awkwardly replied, "Couldn't say." And it's just hilarious. I really enjoy it because it's just really standoffish. It was a very, I mean, they very much ambushed him and as he's just walking to the event with his wife with a microphone. It wasn't a sit down interview or anything along those lines. And he doesn't, he's a rock star. He's a fucking rock star. He shouldn't have to give his predictions on who's gonna win. They put him on the spot and they got shitty answers in return. And I love that he just kind of blew him off a little bit in a way that Dave Grohl doesn't do very often, but he could do his thing. So that was really enjoyable. All right, that is our show for today. We are going to close out with one more song from the show with Third Eye Blind, and so we'll get to that. And again, next week I'm going to be gone on a cruise this next week. But I'm pretty sure a new episode will be out next week still, because we don't miss a beat here on Concert Pipeline, if avoidable. And I'm going to have Chris Slade on the program. Again, he had some time in AC/DC, but he's done a bunch of other music as well. And so the song we're closing out with here is called Slow Motion by Third Eye Blind. And for all of us here at Concert Pipeline, I'm Steve Jones. We'll catch you next time.
Can I also just say, I'm so curious to know what's going on up there on the lawn, because I've spent so much time up there.
Tend to die young.
girl, if you would let me take your pants off. I got a little bit of blow we could both get on. Lady, baby, lady, in the afterglow. Blue lines of coke I cut with Drano. Her nose starts to bleed. A most beautiful baby. Hollywood memorized my ride.